Fourier transform of standard signals. We'll see another standard signals. Find the Fourier transform of complex exponential signals. So in this one, first let us see what is the Fourier transform of e power j omega 0t. As you know that e power j omega 0t is a complex exponential signal of frequency omega naught. So how to prove this? So for this purpose, first to find the Fourier transform of 1. What is the Fourier transform of constant which we have derived? 2 pi into del of omega. The Fourier transform of, so 1, the constant is, which we have derived in the previous class, the Fourier transform of constant is very important formula, 2 pi into del of omega. Now use frequency shifting property. What is the Fourier transform of e power j omega 0t? That means if 1 is multiplied with e power j omega 0t, as explained in the frequency shifting property, remember the frequency shifting property, so what we can write? So if any signal is multiplied with the complex exponential signal, just omega is replaced by omega minus omega naught. So therefore, what is the answer? 2 pi into del of omega minus omega naught. So this is the answer. Just if plus is there, replace with minus. If minus is there, replace with plus. So therefore, very important, e power j omega 0t's Fourier transform is simple formula 2 pi into del of omega minus omega naught. So this is the answer for this simple question. So just use the frequency shifting property. When the signal is multiplied with the complex exponential signal, just replace by omega naught. Let us see the next one. Find the Fourier transform of e power minus j omega 0t. So what we have to do here? So first find the Fourier transform of constant. What is the Fourier transform of constant we have derived? 2 pi into del of omega from duality property we have derived this. So now, so what is the Fourier transform of? So it is multiplied with e power minus j omega 0t term. So multiplied by 1. So here high frequency term is multiplied. So use frequency shifting property. So del of omega plus omega naught. So therefore, what is the answer? E power minus j omega 0t's Fourier transform is simply del of, so 2 pi into del of omega plus omega naught. So this is what the two important properties of complex exponential signals. You have to remember these two formulas, very simple formulas. Now let us take the third one. So let us find the Fourier transform of cos omega 0t. Let us find the Fourier transform of cos omega 0t. So for this purpose, so what we will do is that just cos omega 0t is written as e power j omega 0t plus e power minus j omega 0t by 2. So this is what you can write. Cos omega 0t can be written like this. So therefore, separate 1 by 2 Fourier transform of e power j omega 0t plus 1 by 2 into Fourier transform of e power minus j omega 0t. Just we have derived the Fourier transform of this and this above. So therefore, what you can write? The Fourier transform of this is very simple formula. 2 pi into del of omega minus omega naught plus 1 by 2 into, what is the Fourier transform of this term? 2 pi into del of omega plus omega naught. So cancel out 2 and 2. So take pi as common. If you take pi as common, so the answer is del of omega plus omega naught. I am writing first this term. So del of omega minus omega naught. So this is the Fourier transform of standard function cos omega 0t. So therefore, we can write here cos omega 0t standard function Fourier transform is very simple formula. Just to multiply pi. So del of omega plus omega naught plus del of omega minus omega naught. So this is a very important formula, cos omega 0t Fourier transform. Just let us plot its magnitude and phase spectrum. Just let us plot the magnitude spectrum. So sometimes it will be asked to find the magnitude spectrum. What is this? Magnitude of x of omega versus omega. So this is zero. So what frequencies it has? It has omega is equal to omega naught frequency. So omega is equal to omega naught frequency. And what is the other frequency it has? Omega is equal to minus omega naught frequency. What are the magnitudes of these two frequencies? Pi. So therefore, the magnitudes of these two frequencies are pi. Just to represent pi here. So this is the magnitude spectrum. Magnitude spectrum of cos omega 0t. So let us see the phase spectrum. Phase spectrum. So what is this? Angle of Fourier transform versus omega. So 0. So this is omega is equal to omega 0 frequency. So this is omega is equal to minus omega 0 frequency. Here there is, so there is no complex quantity is there in this equation. So the two phases at this frequency are 0. So this is about your cos omega 0t. Let us take the fourth example. Find Fourier transform of sine omega 0t. Another standard function, sine omega 0t. So let us see what is the answer for this. Write the sine definition. Sine omega 0t is written as e power j omega 0t minus e power minus j omega 0t by 2j. You can write like this. So take 1 by 2j as common. So Fourier transform of the first function. What is the first function? The Fourier transform of e power j omega 0t minus Fourier transform of e power minus j omega 0t. So let us write like this. So therefore 1 by 2j. So what is the Fourier transform of e power j omega standard function? 2 pi into del of omega minus omega naught minus, what is the Fourier transform of this term? 2 pi into del of omega plus omega naught. So what you can do? So you can just cancel out 2 and pi, take pi as common. So j will go to the numerator, it will become minus pi j. So del of omega minus omega naught minus del of omega plus omega naught. So just multiply with the minus sign. So it will become pi j del of omega plus omega naught minus del of omega minus omega naught. So this is the Fourier transform of sine omega 0t. So very, very important formula. Again, you have to remember this formula. Therefore, sine omega 0t's Fourier transform is just pi is same, j you have to add. So del of omega plus omega naught minus you have to place omega minus omega naught. So this is the, for cos omega 0t, j will not be there, plus. For sine, put j and substitute minus sign. So again, let us plot the magnitude spectrum and the phase spectrum of this. So what is the magnitude spectrum? The magnitude spectrum is, as you know, that magnitude of Fourier transform versus omega. So this is 0. What are the frequencies it has? It has omega is equal to omega 0 frequency. Omega is equal to minus omega 0 frequency. So therefore, what is the magnitude? What is the magnitude of this? So the magnitude of this is pi. So you can see that. So both frequencies magnitudes are pi only, because if you separate it will become pi j del of omega plus omega naught minus pi j del of omega minus omega naught. So what is the magnitude of omega is equal to omega naught frequency? Minus pi j. Minus pi j magnitude is pi. So omega is equal to minus omega naught magnitude, amplitude is pi j. It's, if you take the magnitude, it will also come out as pi. So therefore, that is what we have substituted here. Let us just change angle. Let us plot the phase spectrum, that is x of omega versus omega 0. This is one frequency. So write it as omega is equal to omega 0. And this is the another frequency, omega is equal to minus omega 0. So just you can see that at omega is equal to omega 0, what is the phase? Minus j. Minus j in mathematics is, remember that,
minus pi by 2. So it is minus pi by 2. Because 0 minus j. So 0 minus 1j. What is the answer? Tan inverse of minus 1 by 0. Tan inverse of minus infinity. Minus pi by 2. Similarly, at omega is equal to minus omega 0. So what is the phase of this? So 0 plus 1j. For example, say. So what is the answer? Plus pi by 2. So therefore, you have to sketch it. The phase spectrum like this. So this frequency has phase of plus pi by 2. This frequency has a phase of minus pi by 2. So this is about this Fourier transform of standard signals, complex exponential signals and cos omega 0 t and sine omega 0 t. Thank you.